like to share one of my favorite experiences, which is step back and connect the dots. First, who can tell me what comes to your mind after reading such a title?
A game.
Yeah, exactly.
It
almost.
Is a game.
So, yeah.
I like it.
Yeah, exactly. Now, I will begin with the very beginning point of this experience. When I was a child, my dad used to take us on a trip, like going to a well-known mountain in Damascus called the Kasyum. From the top of the mountain, you can see the whole city beneath your feet. It was like an amazing view. Once I was eating my sandwich when my dad approached me. He asked me, "Dear Shefa, what can you really see?" I looked at him and said, "You mean what do I see?" He repeated his question. "No, what can you really see?" I didn't get the point at the beginning. Just look down, try to be wise, try to think thoroughly. And I answered, "I can see millions of lights shining like stars in the sky, sparkling like diamonds in a treasure box." Well, I looked back at his face and just waiting for a strong reaction, you know, for these big words. But on the contrary, he said nothing. He just nodded his head. After a while, he said, "As for me, I can see thousands of lights. Beneath each one, each of them, there is a family that is waiting for someone, celebrating something, suffering out of something, laughing, crying, having dinner." I said, "Wow, are you serious? These are male lights." Of course, I didn't say that to his face, just between myself, me and myself. But actually, he was teaching me to read in between the lines. He was teaching me to look beyond the limits. He was teaching me not to judge a book from its cover. This is the first step, what? To step back, to be able to see the whole picture without getting inside the details. How about connecting the dots? Recently, I've read an article in an economic magazine entitled "Connecting the Dots." The title itself captured my eyes and attracted me a lot because it was, for me, too silly to be found in an economic magazine. It just reminded me with a silly game, like when we were kids, we used to connect the dots to find a horse. Wow, so what? Or an elephant. We used to connect the dots to find a rocket. So what? Actually, after reading the article, I realized that this is not merely a game. It's a whole lifestyle. Yes, because the article was talking about a Chinese person who was a leader, who held the position of leader of a company in its latest stages. It was about to announce its bankrupt, but like in no time, he managed to survive with this company and make it one of the most successful companies in China. How? By connecting the dots. He held weekly meetings among all the managers and responsible people in the company, asked them to discuss all the potential and recent opportunities and threats, and discuss them to find an outcome. What he did, not only spread the spirit of teamwork, he also teach them to look at the same problem from different aspects, to take all consideration before making any decision. So this could be applied individually, could be applied in societies and countries. Before I end my presentation, I just want to ask you one final question. How many steps do you think we have to get back? Actually, it depends on the situation itself. After experiencing, you will be able to find the proper distance where you can stand back to see the whole picture without missing the important details, and then decide. So as a conclusion, I highly recommend every one of you, whether you want to be a leader or not, to step back whenever you face hard times or difficult situation, Just step back, take a breath, and connect the dots. Thank you for your kind listening.